It's about 10 years now that EVs get more and more into the focus of biomedical research, and the main branches, the two branches maybe, might be biomarker discovery and diagnostics and development of EV-based therapeutics. And with regard to the most, to the current landscape, we can say that in these 10 years, the field turned from complete basic research and discovery to at least some developments where it is already being started to come into the clinic. So some university researchers, academic researchers, and also in the biotech scene start now with IND filing. I know from a Boston company where HEC cell-derived EVs are being investigated with regard to their safety and with the intention to treat solid organ tumors. We ourselves have chosen another path, taking naive and genetically non-modified cells like mesenchymal stromal cells and isolating, enriching their EVs, extracellular vesicles, and use these vesicular secretome fractions, and intend to go for IND filing within the next 12 months in a neurodegenerative disorder such as hearing loss. COVID somehow accelerated some of the clinical projects, and with regard to pulmonary disease, it is either infection, COVID infection, or also pulmonary hypertension. Also in the Boston area, there are efforts to investigate EV application systemically, also from stromal cells. This is what I know. We have in Europe other efforts and preclinical and clinical research projects, such as in UK, Evox, and Oxford, where I'm not completely informed how far the clinical development is in the moment, but it is in front. So you can say it is on the edge to entering clinical testing. Other promising avenues are the use of either immortalized cell lines or also cell lines which are derived from embryonic stem cells, but which are then differentiated into a certain lineage. And then maybe certain clones are picked and used for target diseases. One of these examples is from Singapore, where embryonic cell-derived cell lines were differentiated into mesenchymal stromal cells, then were semic transfected and re-immortalized, and may then be used to treat wound healing or epidermolysis bullosa. Another interesting research is also coming from Singapore, where the same EV types are used for bone reconstruction or bone regeneration. So this is also already relatively advanced, as also large animal models have been shown. In our university, also large animals have been used for the investigation of tendon and tendon insertion healing. And also here we have promising results that the tendon of shoulder, for instance, which is a very common disease, the degeneration of shoulder tendons and infraspinatus and supraspinatus tendons. And in this case, we also could show that in a sheep animal models, the natural regeneration and the biomechanic characteristics of the regenerated tendons was very much similar to healthy tendons. And this is very promising research where we could very soon go into clinical translation.